People often think when you ask them about what's going to happen tomorrow, about what the latest technologies or the devices or the, you know, the new techniques using artificial intelligence might be. And it's really important to kind of recenter it on how it's going to change who we are and our behavior and what our priorities are. So I really focus the audience on two big questions. Number one, what's the world going to look like in 2030? So what is the world that we need to prepare kids and students for? How will AI and machine learning and these new technologies combine to transform the way we do everything, from the way we shop, to the way we work, to the way we learn? And then the second part of the question was, what does that mean for the future of education and for educators and for teachers? Although there's a lot of fear and stress at the moment that robots and technology and AI will start to take over jobs, the most important question that we need to ask is not how will technology destroy jobs, but how will technology change jobs and change the skills and capabilities that will be needed to be successful at them? When I say being an algorithmic leader, I don't mean someone who has learned to program or to code. Really, this means somebody who has learned to evolve and adapt and transform to be successful in this new age we find ourselves, an age where intelligent machines and automation are a big part of how the future of the work will get done. And I think there are two very different sets of skills we need to not only develop in ourselves, but to help nurture and coach in others. And the first is a deep understanding of human complexity. Humans are, they're difficult to predict. We're emotional, we're intuitive. You have to understand what it takes to motivate, to connect, to empathize with people. And I think teachers already at a very deep level are masters at this. But this is something that we all need to get better at, because ultimately this is something that machines can never do. But we also need to take on some qualities of machines as well. And the way I put this is we need to develop a flair for computational thinking. It's not the same as learning programming. Computational thinking is the ability to approach problem solving, coming up with ideas or making decisions in a way that's structured enough that allows you to leverage data and technology to amplify your intelligence. There is really a whole host of skills that I think we need to focus on. I mean, probably at the heart of all of them is the recognition that in the future, the most valuable jobs will probably be ones that don't even exist today. And in fact, they'll constantly change. You know, the head of engineering at Airbnb, when he interviews people, actually looks for people that are going to be comfortable with ambiguity. He calls it being energized by unknowns. And that curiosity and comfort with constant change is probably one of the most important skills and capabilities or mindsets that we need to instill. Actually, rather than work, you're going to be hired to design work, to sit in behind the process and go, what's a smarter way of doing this? How can we leverage the latest technology to do this in a new way? And that's going to take someone who can combine both technical skills with ingenuity and creativity. The reality is that there's not going to be a quick fix solution to the skills of the future. It isn't going to be as simple as teaching kids how to code or teaching kids how to use social media. At the heart of it is about, can we do a good enough job instilling a true sense of curiosity and the ability to, you know, to constantly and continuously learn.